first the conclusion of this video. If you suffer from hypertension, then reducing salt will only result in a small and temporary reduction of blood pressure. There will be no long-term reduction of blood pressure because of two control mechanisms in your body. However, reduction of salt has proven negative effects on many other processes in your body. In particular, it results in worsening of insulin resistance and thereby diabetes.
Hello, this is Dr. Emil. Are you one of those many, many people who are every day trying to eat as little salt as possible because your doctor told you that salt is bad? Then this video is important for you because your doctor is wrong and you are damaging your health. This video is in particularly relevant for if you are suffering from type 2 diabetes, whereby your doctor advised you that if you reduce your salt intake, you're going to also reduce your hypertension. Because in this video, I will explain and demonstrate to you that yes, indeed, if you start reducing your salt intake today, it will indeed result in a temporarily and very small reduction of your blood pressure. However, your body has various control mechanisms, and in this video I explain about two systems, the RAAS system, the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, and the stress response systems. And these two systems immediately kick in after you start reducing your salt intake, and these two systems result in a very quick increase of your blood pressure. So reducing salt intake, it does not result in a long-term reduction of your blood pressure. But if you are suffering from diabetes, it will immediately result in an increase of your blood sugar, thereby a worsening of your insulin resistance and thereby a worsening of your diabetes. Please keep watching. So why does your doctor advise you to reduce the intake of salt for when you are suffering from hypertension? Because in theory, your doctor is completely right. Blood pressure is defined by two key parameters. The first one is cardiac output, which is the quantity of blood that your heart muscle pushes through the rest of your body. And the second parameter is vascular resistance. Everybody knows that if you have salt, it attracts water. So if you have a lot of salt in your body, you have more water in your body. Part of that water enters into your bloodstream. So if you have a lot of salt in your blood, then it also means the volume of your blood will be more higher. And that means higher volume means higher blood pressure. Vice versa, if you do not have so much salt in your blood, then the volume of your blood is lower, which means your blood pressure is going to decrease. So does this mean your doctor was right? No, not exactly, because this positive effect of reducing your blood pressure is only a small positive effect, and more importantly, it is only a temporary positive effect, because as soon as your blood pressure starts to decrease, there is two control mechanisms in your body which kick in. One is called the RAAS system and the other one is the stress response system. And these two systems are going to help you very quickly to increase your blood pressure back up again. But more importantly, if you suffer from diabetes, these two systems are also going to worsen your insulin sensitivity. They're going to make you more insulin resistant. It's going to increase your blood sugar and thereby damage. It's going to worsen your diabetes. In the next two paragraphs, first I explain about how these two mechanisms work in increasing your blood pressure. And the next paragraph, I will explain how these two mechanisms, the RAAS, the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, and the stress response system, how they are going to increase, worsen your insulin resistance, and thereby worsen your diabetes. Keep watching. The RAAS system refers to the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, and those are three hormones which are secreted by your kidneys, your liver, and your adrenal glands. It starts with your kidneys, which is the most important organ in your body for regulating blood pressure. So the kidneys is the first organ who is going to notice very quickly that your blood pressure is decreasing immediately after you stop eating salt. And your kidneys respond by creating this substance called renin. This renin enters into your bloodstream, your kidneys see it, and your kidneys react by creating a so-called angiotensin. This is converted in your lungs to the important hormone angiotensin 2. And angiotensin 2 has many effects in your body, but the two most important effects is that it is going to constrict your blood vessels, so your blood vessels get more narrower, and also your body starts to create more norepinephrine, which is a stress hormone which helps in increasing cardiac output. Thirdly, your adrenal glands are going to make more aldosterone. Aldosterone also has many effects in your body, but the three most important ones is that aldosterone is going to try and reduce your urination. It's trying to hold on to as much water as possible. It's trying to reabsorb as much sodium as possible, keep it in your body and in your bloodstream. And certainly it's going to push out a lot of potassium. Potassium and sodium always work together. They need each other. So removing potassium from your body is equally damaging for your body. You need sodium and potassium for every process in your body. Every cell needs it, for example, to produce energy. Cell communication, you need sodium and potassium. Pumping out toxins, pumping out calcium, for example, you need potassium. So this is the RAAS system, and whereby this RAAS system is going to very quickly, after the reduction of blood pressure, make sure your blood pressure increases again. In addition to that, there is the stress response system. When you stop eating salt, salt is an essential mineral, as I explained. It's essential for all the processes in your body. As your body gets lower on salt, your body gets into stress mode, and it reacts also in the adrenal gland by creating a stress hormone in epinephrine. And epinephrine is going to create not only that it's going to result in an increase of blood pressure, but it is also going to result in an increase of blood sugar. And that is what I will explain in the next paragraph. So immediately after your body gets low on salt, immediately your body gets into stress mode. And in this so-called fight or flight mode, your adrenal glands are going to create stress hormones like epinephrine and norepinephrine. And the key thing your body is going to do, in addition to further constricting your blood vessels, it's going to create as much energy, direct usable energy as possible, in the form of glucose, of blood sugar. And it does this via the liver, via the process called gluconeogenesis, whereby your liver quickly converts fat reserves into blood sugar. So very quickly after getting low on salt in your body, your blood sugar levels are going to increase. In relation to the RAAS system, aldosterone has a proven negative effect on insulin sensitivity in your skeletal muscle and in your adipocytes. And that works via various mechanisms, including oxidative stress, inflammation, and downregulation of certain proteins which are relevant for insulin signaling. At the end of this video, a quick summary. If you are suffering from hypertension, and especially if you're suffering from other chronic diseases like diabetes, then please, please, please do not start substantially reducing the intake of salt, because there is zero clinical evidence that reduction of salt is going to help you with reduction of your blood pressure. Maybe there is this small but temporary positive effect, but there is substantial clinical evidence that if you stop eating salt, it is going to worsen your diabetes, it's going to worsen your insulin resistance. And also, please note that salt is essential for all your cells, and thereby it is essential for all the processes in your body. For example, energy production if your cells, it requires salt, potassium, calcium and magnesium. Also, communication between cells, it requires salt. So be careful reducing all your salt intake. The last thing I want to say, I myself, I do not eat any table salt. I would advise you also to stop with table salt and convert, if possible, to something like sea salt or Himalayan salt, because table salt only has two components. It has sodium and chloride. Himalayan salt has a little bit less sodium, but in replacement of that, there is like 80 different important minerals. So that is my last tip and advice. I thank you for watching this video. If you liked this video and you like content like this, then please click on the like and also on the subscribe button. I'm thankful. Thank you.